probably have a great business set and income bhi theek thaak hi hai. But kya aapka man nahi karta to have your company grow, enjoy the luxurious benefits being the owner of the company and even help your employees grow in a healthy work environment? Well, today I'm going to tell you something beyond the basics. That is unlocking the 7 strata of strategy. If you are new here, welcome to Level Up with Hiral, where we discuss everything business, growth and entrepreneurship. Please subscribe so that you don't stop learning even when you're mindlessly scrolling. So for any business to work, there are 3 basic rules that you need to understand. And once you understand these, then you should go ahead and implement the 7 strata of strategy framework. 1. Keep it simple. See, if you can simply explain your business to your dadi, nani or a 10-year-old kid in the house, then your business is most likely to work. If it's overly complicated, it's not just hard for you to communicate, but it also becomes equally difficult for your team and customers to understand your business. And when your team understands, they are most likely to take decisions that align with your business. And when your customers understand this, they are more likely to connect with your brand and recognize its value. 2. Stand out with true differentiation. To succeed, a business has to offer something genuinely unique. Something that separates it from its competitors. Many companies just say we are different without showing how. True differentiation isn't just in the talk, it's embedded in real, observable actions. For example, if you're hiring the same kind of people as your competitors, you can't say your team is unique. Toyota noticed that most car companies hire from the same pool of talent, so they took a different approach. When opening a new factory, Toyota made it a rule to hire people without any prior experience. And this fresh perspective truly sets them apart. Embed your strategy in everything that you do. An effective strategy should be visible in every part of the business, from its culture to daily operations. When a company truly believes in its strategy, it becomes like a central theme around everything that they do. 3M is actually a great example. Their strategy centers around innovation, which isn't just a buzzword. It's their core value, brand promise, purpose, and main performance metric. They embed innovation so deeply into their company that it drives their actions, leading to impressive results. For instance, 3M generates 30% of its revenue from products less than 4 years old, a clear reflection of how thoroughly they commit to their strategy. When strategy shapes every aspect of an organization, it helps create a consistent and a compelling brand identity that drives growth and customer loyalty. The bottom line is, you need a strategy that can be communicated easily, has clear differentiation, and can be repeated. Even better if you can boil down your strategy to a few words. A great example of a strategy that embodies these 3 fundamental characteristics is Domino's. They are quite popular by a 30 minutes or its free delivery guarantee. All they had to do was execute the strategy and it led to tremendous success. Now, if you have understood this, let's proceed to the main segment of this video. That is, how do you create a winning strategy that has these 3 key qualities? And this is where the 7th strata of strategy helps. Own a word or a phrase. Now this word becomes your true identity. Owning a word or a phrase in the market isn't just about having a catchy slogan. It is a guiding principle that shapes the experiences your customers have with your brand. If people hear the word, they should be able to link it to your brand immediately. Here's how a few companies have done it. Tata Group. It is synonymous with trust and innovation. IKEA. Flat packed. In the furniture industry, storage and shipping can be expensive because of bulky items. IKEA's flat-packed approach minimizes these costs, leading to a profit margin of 13% compared to the industry's 2% average. Southwest Airlines wheels up. In an interesting survey, Southwest Airlines realized that they make money every time the plane takes off. Their wheels up strategy is all about getting the plane back in the air as fast as possible, thus increasing profitability and efficiency. Dell, be direct. In Dell's early days, storing parts was costly and devalued inventory. By adopting be direct, Dell only built a computer after the order was placed, thus reducing inventory from 63 days to just 4 days. This strategy helped Dell grow into a billion-dollar company. Each of these companies uses a simple phrase to guide their unique and effective strategies. 2. Declare a brand promise. Create a unique brand promise that's so strong that customers won't mind if you're not the best at everything else. To do this, start by listing down 10 to 12 things that your market wants. Then pick up to 3 that you excel at, and these are your brand promises. The rest becomes things you won't focus on. Tata Group promises reliability, ethical business practices, and a commitment to improving the quality of life of the communities it serves. The idea here is to capture profit share instead of just market share. By winning over a smaller group of customers who give your company big orders, you will be more profitable and thus have a better profit share than your competitors who are chasing everyone. Consider IKEA. They hold only 7% of the global market. market share, yet earn $30 billion annually focusing on what they do the best. Third, create a strong brand promise guarantee. Now, once you've shared your unique brand promise, you need to set up a way that makes it painful for you to break that promise. Hear this again, it should be painful for you to break that promise. This is known as brand promise guarantee. For example, Domino's offers a free pizza if they fail to deliver the pizzas within 30 minutes. This is their way of backing up their promise. 4. Create a one-phrase strategy. After defining your three brand promises, the next step is to sum them up in a simple one-phrase strategy. For product-based businesses, this is relatively easy because you can give each product its own name. However, it is trickier for service-based businesses. So let me give you an example. There is an SEO firm in Barcelona called Goss & Newman. At that time, a while ago, there were just 7 employees and it was just another SEO firm. The founder of the company wanted to do SEO in a special way that was different from everybody else. To help him explain his new idea, he hired really smart people like physicists and mathematicians who usually work with numbers on the Wall Street. Instead of focusing on the normal 150 words or so, he wanted to optimize a lot more, up to 10 to 15 million words. Now, to make it easier for people to understand what he was doing, he came up with a cool new name for this: mask marketing. Mask stands for massive, arrayed, structured keyword marketing, which tells everyone exactly what their company does and how it is different from others. To spread the word about mask marketing, he wrote special reports called white papers that compared regular advertisement to his new approach. Because of this, he got attention from the Forbes magazine, which even helped him land 2 of the largest clients in the United States. 5. Outline differentiating activities. What if another company has the same brand promise as you? How can you stand out? The key is in your activities. Patanjali differentiates itself in the market by effectively leveraging traditional Ayurvedic knowledge in its product formulations. This focus on authenticity, natural ingredients, and a strong cultural connection not only appeals to health-conscious customers, but also positions Patanjali as a leader in the natural wellness industry. By constantly coming up with new ideas, educating people, and focusing on sustainability, Patanjali has created a special place for itself in the competitive market. For Southwest Airlines that we spoke about earlier, their main goal was wheels up, meaning they wanted to get their planes in the air faster and more often than the competitors. To achieve this, they made 3 promises: low fares, more flights, and more fun. While anyone could claim these promises, the real difference lies in how they operate. To differentiate their pricing and achieve low fares, they eliminated baggage fees that other airlines charge. They use Boeing 737 planes for all flights, which makes it easier to manage their parts, maintenance, and pilots. While other airlines juggle multiple aircrafts, Southwest Airlines streamlined its operations to get more planes in the air. Next, they have a no advance reservation policy, encouraging passengers to board quickly to get the best seats possible. This allows them to load and unload planes 15 minutes faster compared to the other airlines, hence allowing them fitting in more flights each day. They also do not serve any food, which means they save on extra time which would have otherwise been spent on loading and unloading the food trays and even on the cleaning after. 6. Establish your X factor. Creating a winning strategy isn't just about beating your competition, it's about staying ahead of them. The X factor is what gives you a significant advantage, 10 to 100 times more than your competitors. This X factor is not obvious to others. In Fevicol's strategy, they emphasize that the bond created with Fevicol is as strong as family relationships in India. This emotional approach is a key aspect of Fevicol's marketing, showcasing the idea that their product fosters connections that are reliable and long-lasting, just like the bonds within Indian families. 7. Measure your profit per X. Once you've identified your key advantage, it's time to scale it up. A great way to do this is by focusing on a single important metric: profit per X. This doesn't necessarily have to be profit. It can be gross margin or revenue. The key is to figure out what X will be. And don't confuse this with X factor, by the way. That is totally different. X represents your unique perspective on the market. While everyone else in the airline industry looked at profit per seat, profit per passenger, or profit per mile, Southwest Airlines chose to measure profit per plane. This aligned with their approach of getting their wheels up. Next, you also need to set a big, hairy, audacious goal. Hindi mein bolu to apne aukaat ke bahar. But to scale effectively, this goal should match profit per X. For Southwest, their big goal was to have 346 planes in the air by 2010. With a clear goal, they could plan everything backwards. 10 years later, they not only reached their goal, but also became one of the most profitable airlines. This is an effective framework to create a winning strategy that differentiates you from others and also gets you way ahead of your competition. Once you have the strategy in place, it's just a matter of executing it. I hope I was able to provide value through this video, guys. Please like, share, subscribe. You know the drill for more such videos. And ciao for now.